bodies and won't get changed. Swimsuits, people, hurry, chop, chop.
It's time to head to the beach, take in some rays, and enjoy all of that plot development.
The bikinis! Woo-hoo! Let's hit on chicks!
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 best anime beach episodes. Craving more otaku entertainment? Be sure to check out our latest magazine, WatchMojo's Top 100 Anime of All Time. For this list, we're taking a look at those mindless filler beach episodes that put our favorite characters in rather compromising situations. Also, we will be excluding episodes that feature hot springs or onsen, as that is a list for another day. Number 10, Demon of the Deep Seas, Blue Exorcist.
What the hell?
Just because you're going to the beach doesn't mean you can't get some work done. Rin and company are sent to the beach on a mission, if you could call it that, to get some R&R.
Figure we get stuck flipping squids at the shop all day, with all these voluptuous babes around.
A major excuse to have fun and goof off. The cast slips into their swimsuits and have a ball, giving fans plenty to watch.
I haven't felt this way in ages.
While this is interrupted by the appearance of a kraken offshore, this just adds to the overall appeal. Who doesn't love exorcists fighting in shorts and bikinis, right? Number 9. No one sleeps at camp. Haganai.
When I give you the signal, shout as loud as you can. Pick any pose you want. Ready? I'll go first. 1, 2...
Yay, ocean!
Nothing is better than laying on the beach and soaking up some sun with your friends. Or at least until things get a tad bit crazy.
Like what?
Like when a girl is cold and she crawls into a boy's sleeping bag.
Quit being such a weird pervert.
On a mini vacation to their beach house, the neighbors club decides to hit the beach and make things a little interesting. One member proposes humiliation play, which means each character humiliating each other. This results in a handful of rather provocative scenes, such as a massage on the beach turning into a foot rub with just a tad too much lotion.
You like feeling helpless. Do you want to be told what to do, totally humiliated, and forced to perform exclusively for my entertainment?
This is pretty much the textbook definition of fan service, but it does hit all the points that fans could hope for in a beach episode.
Senna! I never knew your tatas were so big!
Well, you know where to find me when you're ready to do it.
I hate you!
Number 8, Save Me at the Beach. Save me, I'm naked. Just save me for real. School Rumble.
Wow, your swimsuit looks totally hot, Akira.
What about mine? Pretty daring, huh?
Makoto's suit makes her boobs look even bigger.
Your suit's pretty cute too, Tenma.
Thanks!
If there is one takeaway from this show, it's that nothing goes well for Harima. After a relaxing session of practicing martial arts in the nude, Harima is mistaken for peeping on the ladies in the spa.
Wait, don't tell me. You took off your clothes and went to find your swimming trunks. You looked all over, couldn't find them, and then Eri walked in. You tried to explain yourself, she got scared, and your infinite wisdom led us to where we are now. Don't worry, Harima. I don't think you're a pervert, but you are a total screw-up.
Of course, things escalate, and this case of being in the wrong place at the wrong time provides fans with the awkward and funny moments that the show is known for.
Here, take it.
Thank you, Nara. Huh?
Boy, you're a klutz, Harima! Aren't you lucky Nara was so close to me and able to find your trunks? Isn't he the greatest?
Even after he's cleared of all wrongdoing, things continue to go from bad to worse for our unfortunate hero. It's also unfortunate because we all know who the real pervert in this show is.
Yep, that'll do it. A signal fire.
We don't have any matches or anything to burn.
We'll burn our swimsuits.
And whose were you planning to burn first?
Well, yours does have one more piece than mine.
Number 7, Training Camp. K-On.
Ready, and ho!
Determined to train for their upcoming comeback performance, the Light Music Club decides to practice at a beachside villa. Things have been pretty stressful for the group lately, and it's really important to the show's audience that the girls get a chance to unwind in their swimsuits.
Eat this!
However, due to the nature of this show, fan service in this episode is actually pretty tame, and instead, audiences get a lot of heartfelt and honest moments between the characters. Open opens up in this episode, and Ritsu learns the hard way to not get on her bad side.
That one turned out great. Actually, I have that shot of...
Hand over the negatives now.
It's a digital camera. There's no negatives.
Number 6, hot summer day, courtship behavior, guilty crown. It doesn't quite make it a hot and romantic beach day without a confession of some kind.
I think it's high time we got in the water already.
Actually, I was just gonna...
Hurry up!
Oh.
On this trip to the Sandy Paradise, our heroes travel to a beach resort to try to unlock Shu's vision, a gigantic weapon with special properties. What follows is a hilarious, yet romantic encounter as Shu tries to confess his love for Inori, all while Sota tries to prevent the encounter from happening at all. While Sota does succeed, it isn't without a few mistakes and hilarious moments for the viewer. Will they ever live this down? Probably not.
Hurry up, Slowpokes!
Why's he gotta be so ridiculous all the time?
Sota's just being himself.
Number 5. Trial in open water. Free Iwatobi Swim Club.
無人島だね!
だからなんでそんなに無人島好きなんですか?
Now, here's a real challenge. How can you make a fan service beach episode when the characters are already barely wearing anything to begin with? Well, Free pulled it off, thank God. In order to practice long distance swimming, the Iwatobi decides to practice in the ocean, Makoto's mortal enemy. This episode is already hilarious to begin with, but the stakes are amped up with a near kiss between the main characters.
Makoto!
It may have just been a tease, but so close. What? They're good-looking dudes. Number 4. Yoko, will you do me a favor? Gurren Lagann.
What's with the absurd outfits?
No. If you've come to the sea, you've got to go swimming. You've got no choice.
As well as swimming, we'll be able to confirm if the water is salty.
That's right. Get into your swimsuits and let's go swimming.
When you need some downtime for repairs, the ideal place to relax is at the beach. Just a mere stop on the way to the Beast Men's capital, Team Dai Gurren decide to wind down with some beach games.
Perfect. When it comes to contests of physical power, I am obviously the...
Unlike most beach episodes, the plot actually develops, and the team is ambushed under dire circumstances. Yoko, one of anime's sexiest characters of all time, is actually wearing a fairly conservative swimsuit, and teaches the audiences a lesson in trust as she takes a shot no other sniper could have made. As far as beach episodes goes, if you're looking for fan service, you gotta look elsewhere. But if you want a solid story-driven episode, this one lands top marks.
Let's ride this wave straight to shore!
Number 3, Summer Seal Swimsuit Festival, Bleach.
That's all there is to it. The Women's Soul Reapers Association decided to come here for a little R&R.
Even Shinigami need to unwind every once in a while. In desperate need of a vacation, the Soul Reaper Association decides to relax at, you guessed it, a beach. But that gets rudely interrupted by a group of watermelon monsters. No, that is not a euphemism.
Chad and I will keep it busy until you can get your substitute Soul Reaper pass.
Yeah.
That's a good idea, thanks!
Despite the common beach episode tropes, the episode also reveals a Reaper's major weakness, that they are nothing without their weapons.
Watch where you're putting that tentacle! Get that vine out of my swimsuit!
Oh damn, why didn't I bring my camera today?
As long as you don't take this episode too seriously, it's a lot of fun.
All we have to do is make some cleavage by pushing our boobs together and we can carry all the water we need.
You're so smart.
Here, let me show you how it's done. Just grab your boobs like this.
It's broad daylight! What do you think you're doing?
Hmm? Booby buckets.
Disallowed!
Number 2, Drifters of the Dead. High School of the Dead.
If I don't eat soon, they're going to shrink! To double D!
For a series that really pushes sexual objectification to the limits, it's kinda hard to even imagine what a beach episode might bring to the table.
Look at me! This is what I've got!
This infamous OVA follows our main group as they escape to a supposed zombie-free island. after Takashi accidentally burns hydrangea leaves to make fire. All of the characters suffer hallucinations of, shall we say, a sexual nature.
I am a revolution!
Just like anything straight out of fanfiction, each of the characters starts pairing up and hooking up. It still combines fan service with comedy very well, as Takashi believes that all four girls who want to be with him turn out to be zombies.
Shizuka, you of all of them should know better than this. You're a teacher, a nurse, but still this is wrong. But it sort of feels too right to be wrong.
Before we play in the sun with our top pick, here are a few honorable mentions.
Yes!
What the heck was that for?
Much better. You're supposed to be excited about seeing me in a swimsuit, Yuji.
Number 1, Remote Island Syndrome, the melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya.
It's really cool to meet you, Mr. Master! But let's cut to the chase. Has anything strange ever happened in this house? What about the island? You hear any stories from the locals?
No one really does a beach episode quite like Haruhi Suzumiya. Instead of taking the normal approach of providing an excuse for the main cast to step into something a little more revealing for mindless fun, we get an interesting murder mystery on a remote island. With obvious references to famous detective anime such as Detective Conan, this episode makes sure you get both the suspense of an intriguing mystery, as well as all of the fun in a day in the sun. Hey man, you can't stop the SOS Brigade from having a blast.
Now I've got it. I know what happened in there. Are you even listening to me?
Yeah, come on then, let's hear it.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from WatchMojo and subscribe for new videos every day.